Hello, everyone. This is Will Detrill here. I am at the 2023 annual air conditioner meet at Mike's Place in New Jersey. And so, unfortunately, not too many people are here this year because, Mike had to reschedule. So, of course, that screwed everything up, unfortunately. And this is all the units that are here. Like, right here, this is my 1980 Sanyo rotary cool, large chassis. Here, the other two units you know about. The one that's running right now is the 8300 BTU Q-Star. And the one on the bottom is the 5400 BTU Q-Star that I found a sleeve for. The top one, the Q-Star, the top Q-Star, the 8300 BTU, Christian, also known as a Weather Wheel HVAC, he is a potential buyer for this unit. And it's blowing nice and cold. I'm just letting it run, just it's nice and hot. That's hot. Oh, look at that, that's iced over. Yeah, as you see, the beginning of the capillary tube, that's starting to freeze over. So I'm going to give it a little time to see if it fades, see if it melts, and we will see what happens. So some of you may be familiar with this, the Sears View Saver, Sears Cold Spot View Saver. This is actually a unit Chris Beck brought over. That's so cool.
Lots of them. I know they set up immediately. They did a lot of shit. It wasn't cheap.
As if we haven't been through enough of Red Ring 2.
Yeah, now I'm doing an official video.
Like,
you thought like it wasn't.
Yeah, well.
I'm trying to fool a few.
Pretty cool.
Yep.
It's an old recording of 92.3 K-Rock, WXRK, out of New York City.
Yeah,
unfortunately, no longer exists.
Yeah.
Like, copy and took set for my personal air check collection.
Yeah, let me show you. Yes, sirree. Alright, I better get out of here before I get a copyright strike.
I would.
Some of you may know this unit. Antique Emerson fan. Here's the 20,000 BTU weather wheel. Whoops, sorry. Damn it. Sorry about that, guys. Alright, that looks a little better.
It's rough though.
I don't chip
Have you seen the inside of it?
No, it's rotten.
It's rotten.
What is it?
It's an old General Electric.
It's a five-footer, I guess. It looks good from 5 feet away.
Well, honestly, if I found one, I would say five or five.
Is a piece
yes, so...
I can't remember what it is.
So yes, so this is...
Basically from Midwest to bed. Yeah. Solid door, window, enamel color?
Solid door. Solid.
Okay.
Yes, blue.
I bought boxes that were...
Yeah, that element's literally... It's just sitting there. It's fucking wired.
So by the time this thing was done,
coils are not attached to
the which is how you want to do it.
Yeah.
And then you have the little coil at the bottom. It's a plug and play. That pulls out. It's got two huge coils.
Unfortunately, Mike said that this medium chassis, Emerson Quiet Cool, it's unfortunately on its way out. The compressor, at least.
But I just want one.
As you can hear.
Here,
let me show you outside.
Interview model. I've got a 1960 GE double oven. Same one. The top one has a window, the bottom is a solid door, and it's stainless steel.
Well, you don't hear it as much on the outside, but you can definitely hear it on the inside. Well, it's all because of the Space Girl. The Space Girl is killing this unit. Well, so far so good at this meet. The Space Girl hasn't done anything except the only thing the Space Girl's done is is knock over Michael's coffee pot.
Yeah, I mean it's nothing special, but I'm surprised that I was able to find the leak and then braze the hole shut.
Oh, I can believe that.
I never braced before.
All right, I'm gonna check on
that
Q Star. Oh, it's blowing nice and cold. There you go, the frost is starting to melt. How does the cord feel? And it's a little bit warm on this part of the extension cord. It's a little bit warm. Barely warm, a little bit, not much. Yeah, the Q-Star is running good. Just making sure it's fully functional before I sell it to Christian. Yeah, so I was just explaining to the viewers that the Space Girl is slowly killing Mike's EQK.
Poor EQK. It doesn't deserve to go out like that.
No, no. All because of the Space Girl. Fuck you, Space Girl.
Yeah, take a hike.
Yep. Yeah, now that I think about it, she's definitely doing more than just...
We got some condom ints.
Nice.
Yeah, she's definitely doing more than just... she's slowly but surely killing the EQA besides knocking over his coffee pot.
It's really hard to see, but... Here, I'll show you what you're talking about. What were we just talking about? I'm going to say something better. I'm here for so far.
Oh, from the music?
Oh my god, yeah. We went some dogs first. We were kind of singing for that. Yeah, you weren't even here for the freaking, that was freaking loud. You live in New Jersey, right?
I actually...
I'll be back in a bit. Chrysler AirTemp Imperial startup.
Right.
sounds nice. Quiet enough it'll make a perfect 12-hour ASMR video with the sound of this unit. Now it's starting to produce its unique sound now that it's gaining pressure. The air conditioner guy had this unit. Now, weather wheel HVAC owns this unit. You on top of the unit. That's how smooth this thing's running. Like, most rotary compressors don't run this smooth. The Toshiba rotary is one of the smoothest. Definitely the Toshiba the GE rotary, and even the Matsushita is a fairly smooth running rotary. But this is definitely very smooth. Every recip has their smooth running compressors, all recips. Okay, now, so that's a little bit of ASMR for you, and now, for Chris Beck's View Saver by Sears Cold Spot. Compressors on this side, a View Saver. That's okay, at least you still have one.
Yeah.
I'll restore mine eventually.
I love the two sides.
The double sided.
Actually started or not? Usually hear a little bit of vein rattle when it starts up. For instance, like a real short instant.
And working with some lower voltage.
Yeah. Runs on like medium fan and then it goes to low fan.
And once it reaches,
yeah,
it's
once
close
it reaches
to
a certain point.
Yeah. Is that going to change for sure prestige? And it has the same feature.
Yeah.
Like, if it's. Yeah. If it's warmer in the room, it runs on high cool. as it gets down to the temperature before the thermostat can cook off, it'll hear a click. Mm-hmm. It kicks out a low fan and finishes it off. It doesn't really turn all the way on.
Okay. This one will turn all the way on.
Yep, that's the view saver. Okay, so now that there's 220 volts here, I finally get to see if this thing actually works. Like, I'm a little concerned because there's a piercing valve right here. Like, so now, hopefully this has a full charge. Oh, I gotta wait for Christian to get his camera.
That's having the same panel as my Panasonic does almost on it.
Okay, yeah, that's
not, yeah. DNA is there.
Nice.
Heat and odds are the same, almost.
Not necessarily. So. Now, this is to know if I know if it works and for any potential buyer. Like,
this is a rotary cool.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
Ooh. Blowing stuff everywhere.
Something, eh? It's getting closer. Very well. Not much yet. Well, give it a minute. It's a rotary. So.
Yeah, it's a rotary.
You like that. It never wear out.
Oh, yeah. Whoa. It's been sitting in my car for months. I just want it gone.
Something's happening.
A little bit.
Yeah, let it go for a bit. I don't know.
Yeah, I'll stall the motor.
Stall the motor. Oh, it's starting.
Oh, there you go.
It's got a hole on the evap now. Top of this. Something.
Ooh, warmth on the condenser.
I gotta say, that's a pretty quiet compressor.
How big is it?
I guess around 18,000, 19.
It's getting warm.
Ooh. Yep, starting to get warm. There you go.
There you go.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. She's blowing heat.
Oh, good, good. Yeah, I should
hopefully
let this run.
Going away.
Yeah, I should let this run for a few minutes. Yeah, because especially since it's got constant run, like it'll help. At least it's got something. Like I'll know for a fact. Like once I run it for a few minutes. Yeah, it definitely will.
Coming back
home. Yeah, we'll be back.
Is it coming back
cold?
Yeah. Well, so far so good. It's blowing cold. Blowing nice and cold.
It works though.
Yeah, it's doing good. Like, the condenser is definitely hot. Yeah, the condenser is hot.
Oh, that feels pretty good.
Yeah.
The rotaries always come up slow.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, yeah, that feels good.
Yeah, it does.
How many BTUs is this?
I think around 18 or 19,000. Because it doesn't really say.
Really?
No. I'm surprised.
Doesn't look too rusty.
Not really, no. Except for the shroud.
Well.
Yeah.
Is it a match of sheet
rust or?
Yeah, it's hard to see.
Quiet.
Yeah, definitely. No. No, like the as far as I know, the sleeve got destroyed, like while being removed from the wall, before it was put up for sale. Yeah, it does. All right, give it another few minutes, and we'll see what happens.
Well, for a rotary compressor, that actually sounds pretty good.
It sounds good, and it sounds quiet, too.
It's got a nice finger chopper in there.
Yep.
That does have the grill, but it's no case.
Yep.
And this does have air scan, right, or air sweep or something.
Yep, it did.
Oh,
but
it does.
It has a little notch here.
Actually, it's attached to the grill.
It is, and when you put the grill on it, you're supposed to kind of line it up with this.
Let me see if I can try putting this on.
It does work, too, look.
Yeah, it does work, yeah.
It's a shame it don't have a case. I wonder what case this had.
Yeah, probably similar to a GE, like.
Because I know of a house in Levittown that is actually... I have pictures that I took recently that has an old Sandio case through the wall yet with the modern POS inside of it.
Yeah. Probably had this.
It could be. It looks cool. It has like five rows of freaking vents on the
back.
Yeah, yeah. It's neat looking.
Got that towards the front, right?
All right,
let's try it.
Yep, there you go. Oh, yeah, perfect.
Nice. You got it.
Awesome.
Cool.
You got the air scan working?
Yeah.
Yep.
What's the BTUs on this? 18?
Around there.
Yeah, it does work, too. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's weird how it's integrated with the actual grill. It's not like in there.
Well, that's how my noiseless is, but the noiseless is that's in a league of its own, though.
That has its own contraption, like the motor's still in there.
For anyone who wants to know what I'm talking about, I have tons of those in my videos of that on my channel. I don't know how to talk about.
Yeah. Give it another.
No promises if it falls off. Oh, it's starting to fall off.
Try and see if we can fire up that reticle.
Here, I guess. And I give it another few minutes. Okay, so I guess this is a win for this unit. I'm very happy it's got a full charge. So this feels cold. This is blowing ice cold. The condenser is nice and hot. So I'm gonna go ahead and shut this off. Okay, gonna shut this off. A little bit of a clunk, not too bad. All right, so we'll make a potential buyer happy that this thing works. Just needs a sleeve, that's all. Well, this is like towards the end of the meet, and everybody's taking their units home. So 3648 White Westinghouse. He just bought my sign. He just bought the sign your rotary pool. So he's just gonna start loading it up soon. He just has to pull his car up.
I might as well freaking give that back to him. That's crazy, and this freaking was using the game.
So
it's actually been freaking taken.
There's something wrong with the...
So a couple guys are over there, like, talking about audiophilia. And then then later on we're going to do a little more audio.
Wonderful music, that's what Frankie from the Bronx says. Thank you, Frankie, for your pleasure support. Terry from Myrtle Beach, we thank you. Michelle from Alexandria.
Yep, so they're just talking about audiophilia, so... Okay, so now we are going downstairs.
We're going off of Mike's vinyl collection, and we're going to make a mixed 8-track just for the occasion. So everybody here is going to pick a song. I already have mine picked out. I have Badlands by The Boss, and then once it loops around, we should be in a 40-minute tape, we should be able to fit more than 5 songs on it. And once it loops back to me, we're going to do Cats in the Cradle by Harry Chapin. So while Badlands is playing, what we're going to do is I'm going to have the next person pick a song out. It's going to be cool. Like no one really does stuff like this.
Nope.
Okay. So yeah, we're gonna make this tape, and it'll live in infamy forever. Yes.
Oh yeah.
All right, Christian, we're good. Yeah, I'm not gonna put every single song on, but we can show it getting started.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're wrong.
I get close.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't post the songs on YouTube because I'm obviously.
Case for the Black Keys, at Mike.
So. If you want to listen to this to the music, like I'll post it on my Flickr page, because like there's because that they
awesome
don't do
album. One of my favorite artists.
Yep.
I just wish he'd shut up sometimes.
Yeah.
My mom actually went to see Bruce Springsteen a couple days ago, I think, right? Yeah, a couple days ago.
Oh, sure. I know he just canceled a bunch of tour dates.
Yeah.
He's not really doing too good right now. Hopefully he's all right.
Yeah. Honestly, I kind of regret not going.
Oh, the Promised Land.
I saw.
I'm set on the bad leg. Like, K-track, you see if this deck has a pause button. You have a new, I don't know if you can see it.
I'm gonna
pressure pad, and foil splice has been backed up. Oh, we got to do some Billy Joel.
Yeah. I'm going to pick my favorite song off this album.
Let me guess. Sales. I've loved These Days.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's my favorite one off that album, yep. too. All right, so is this already set up, Mike, or do we have to?
We're gonna have to
adjust the patches.
We're gonna have to test it out.
Do it. I'll put it on.
Well, first of all, we gotta set it.
Where's the right program? It's on program 2. All right. So we want to put it on.
Oh, that we can change without a
one.
Okay, now this video is gonna be posted on my Flickr page.
Probably auto eject on 4.
Nope. Is there a pause button?
There is no pause button, so you have to hit stop. Every time we want to hit record.
Oh, that's badass. So you hit stop and play, they get to go again. So you don't have to, you do
record and play, I think.
No shit, so it's like a cassette deck.
Yeah. So this is going to be a little bit of a, let's get our first album queued up.
Yeah, good idea. Just want to make sure
that's that one.
Actually, why don't we do this? We can leave the tape out. We can probably get a level set.
Yeah, we're going to have to do that. Theoretically, the vinyl should all be about the same, right?
What track are
you? Badlands. Opening track.
You want to get it going?
It will get in the middle, but it's going to be loud.
So I'm going to do.
Shit. I'm supposed to put it in manual, I think. Would it do it cycle?
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
So good. And the burglars.
Of course, you gotta set any kind of tape, you gotta set the levels.
Levels are good.
We're not recording hot.
Oh my god, that's crazy.
This concludes the 2023 Air Conditioner Meet, aka Audiophile Meet, so. Thank you, Mike.
And it does not have to be a year until we do it again.
Yep.
It does not have to be a year.
No, it doesn't have to be a year. So.
I got my phone and this irreplaceable 8-track cartridge.
Yeah.
The best part about it is that one Billy Joel song that freaking skipped. That was freaking funny.
Yeah.
I want to laugh at that every time I hear it. Like,
yeah, and we all yell, "Fuck you, Space Girl."
Yep. Fuck you, Space Girl.
Yeah.
Oh, I got a 2.5-hour drive. Hopefully, I can make it in 2 on the way.
Oh, you'll make it in 2.
Yeah,
I'm sure you will.
I hope so. I'm sure you're gonna. Once I get into PA, I'll be rolling 90 the whole way. I don't fuck around in Jersey though without an out-of-state plate. Turnpike just kind of. They don't care.
Certainly do 80 on the turnpike. I've done it before.
Yeah. Well, so thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to hit like.
Who's taking all the cookies with him?
Hit subscribe. And don't forget to always love. Have a good one.